after that, you wake up and you have to now start working for your dream, you know? And most people, what they do is they forget working about it. They just dream.
Hey guys, I'm Ronak and you are listening to the Ronak Shah Show. Today we have another great personality, Mr. Kevin Mesa. Who sold more than 50,000 copies. Who wrote first book at the age of 12 and published at the age of 14. Before we start our podcast, why don't you share with your friends? Let them know about this podcast. So Mr. Kevin, firstly, welcome to the podcast. And why don't you little bit brief about your journey of writing?
My name is Kevin Solomon Missel. ये मेरा पूरा नाम है.
Okay.
ज़्यादा लोगों को पता नहीं है, तो लोग जब मेरा साइन देखते हैं बुक्स में, वो बोलते हैं यार ये सॉलोमन कौन है? मैंने बोला यार मेरा मिडिल नेम है.
Okay.
Yeah. So that is one thing. Also, I'm 22 years old, and
yeah,
I started writing at the age of 14. My first, okay. I started. Well, actually, लिखा तो मैंने 12 साल से था पहले.
Yeah.
12-13 साल में, and then I have written till now 4 books, and उसमें से 3 books no one knows about. only one book they know about, which is Kalki, of course.
Okay.
So I'm a graduate of St. Stephen's College from Delhi.
Okay.
Where? What?
Okay, I said okay.
Okay. अच्छा. And अभी मैंने history honors से graduate हुआ हूँ. अभी क्या? 1.5 साल हो गए हैं. So now I'm a professional writer. And बस यार, I'm chilling यार. और क्या?
So now you are full time writer.
Yep.
Okay. So regarding to this, like how you differentiate your personal life and professional life?
Yeah, differentiate तो कर नहीं पाता. थोड़ा problem हो जाता है, लोग आ जाते हैं, बोलते हैं यार तू लिखना बंद कर, एक party कर हमारे साथ. You know, but what I do is, तो मेरा एक idea है, funda है कि you know, so I work very fast, okay? So that's the best thing about me, I work very fast. तो मैं क्या करता हूँ ना, मैं अपनी किताबें ना एक-एक महीने में खत्म कर देता हूँ.
Oh, great.
Yeah, so I take like a month off from the 12 months and I just finish it. Ki matlab, you know, ki fir baaki time pe main aaram se personal life pe enjoy kar sakta hu, while ek mahina hai jisme main kaam karta hu, you know.
Okay.
Yeah. And so, marketing ke time pe I think main kafi matlab main balance karna padta hai, but balance mein kar nahi pata, to meri jo girlfriend se mujhe chhod ke chale jati hai. बोलती है तुम्हारे पास टाइम तो है नहीं, क्या क्या मतलब मेरे साथ क्या रह रहे हो तुम. या
वेल दैट्स अ प्रीटी गुड स्टोरी.
बताइए.
यस, लाइक यू स्टार्टेड सो अर्ली टू राइट, आई मीन व्हाट आर योर फैमिली थॉट अबाउट इट?
दे वर क्वाइट सपोर्टिव यार, आई मीन सिंस द बिगिनिंग ओनली, जब मैं पहली बार लिख रहा था, दे वर क्वाइट सपोर्टिव. इनफैक्ट माय डैड वांटेड मी टू रीड, माय मॉम वांटेड मी टू रीड, यू नो. बचपन में ऑब्वियसली तुम अब सीधा यू नो पॉलो कोएलो तो पढ़ोगे नहीं, तो स्टार्टिंग में मेरे को आर्ची कॉमिक्स पढ़वाए थे, यू नो,
राइट,
समझ जाओ कुछ, यू नो, टू गेट द डायलॉग, टू गेट व्हाटएवर हाउ द नरेटिव गोस,
राइट.
तो उसके बाद फिर उसके बाद यू नो दे वर द वंस हु लॉन्च मी, दे हेल्प मी टू लॉन्च माय फर्स्ट बुक 14 इयर्स में, 14 साल के बच्चे को लॉन्च करवाया, यू नो देमसेल्फ.
वही, दैट्स अ बिग थिंग एक्चुअली.
या सो दे वर क्वाइट सपोर्टिव अबाउट माय राइटिंग, बट ऑब्वियसली नो वन थॉट दैट इट विल बी अ करियर, यू नो.
ओके.
एंड अब माय यू नो इनिशियली माय पेरेंट्स वर लाइक कि यार पैसे कमा पाएगा तो उसको प्रोफेशन में, लाइक अधिकारियों का प्रोफेशन. Like, let's be honest, Ronak, I mean, writers are not the richest people in the world.
Right.
So, but yeah, I mean, so after Kalki, I mean, by God's grace, I mean, things are going well. Now they don't question my profession because I'm earning quite well. At the same time, I'm enjoying doing what I love. So, yeah.
नहीं, एक्चुअली प्रॉब्लम क्या होता है कि अगर कोई ऑथर बनना चाहता है लाइक अर्ली स्टेज में, तो फैमिली बोलते हैं पहले कुछ तो अच्छा करियर चूज कर ले, देन उसके बारे में सोचना.
या माय डैड सेड दैट, माय डैड वाज लाइक यार एक्चुअली ग्रेजुएट हो जाए, यू नो, यू डोंट जस्ट जंप ऑफ टू राइटिंग इमीडिएटली आफ्टर 12.
ओके.
सो आई सेड ठीक है, ग्रेजुएट हो जाता हूं. सो माय डैड एंड मॉम वांटेड मी टू बी पार्ट ऑफ सेंट स्टीफन्स कॉलेज बिकॉज़ वो काफी प्रेस्टिजियस कॉलेज है. तो बोले वहाँ से ग्रेजुएट हो जाए. या वहाँ से ग्रेजुएट हो जाए, देन यू थिंक अबाउट व्हाटएवर यू वांट टू डू, दैट्स योर चॉइस. सो एक्चुअली आई हैड दिस, सो बेसिकली क्या हुआ था ना, बीच में क्या हुआ था, आई हैड दिस बैड time in my life where basically I couldn't write anything. Okay.
तो
उस टाइम पे क्या था कि दैट्स व्हेन माय डैड पेरेंट्स वर रिकंसीडरिंग दैट आई थिंक आई माइट नॉट बी अ राइटर आफ्टर ऑल यू नो
ओके
पर अब मैं शायद से कुछ और ही बनूंगा तो दे थॉट कि तू फिल्म मेकिंग में ट्राई कर ले यू नो और ट्राई समथिंग एल्स ट्राई अ क्रिएटिव फील्ड ऑफ कोर्स बट लाइक गो समवेयर एल्स
या
सो बट यू नो थिंग्स वर्कड आउट आई सैट डाउन वन समर ड्यूरिंग द समर डेज एंड आई जस्ट रोट काल्की एंड आई थिंक दैट चेंज्ड माय लाइफ So,
okay. So actually, based on this, like the biggest ups and downs in your life, like we come to know your biggest down, like the bad phase of your life.
Okay.
What is the biggest
down for my life? Biggest down could be the fact that बहुत सारे यार.
Like one of them, like you would like to share with every listener, like to get rid of that phase.
Okay. I think it was during the time where I was not writing at all. ठीक है मैंने ना क्या हुआ था मेरी पहली किताब जो लिखी थी ना उसके बाद मैं चली नहीं किताब obviously you know people don't care about that book है ना but I got the first royalty of 20,000 rupees so I was very happy
okay
yeah but so what happened was कि I got तो चली नहीं किताब तो यार मेरे को भी लगा कौन कौन राइटर बनेगा राइटर के वेबसाइट पॉइंट से आईडी बनेगा है ना तो देन आई वाज हैविंग द स्पोर्ट्स डे हो रहा था मेरे स्कूल में ठीक है आई वाज आई थिंक इन 10th क्लास
ओके
एंड आई गॉट टू नो दैट स्पोर्ट्स में भी अच्छा नहीं हूं मैं ठीक है अब यार सी आई वाज नेवर अ स्पोर्ट्सी गाय ठीक है एंड माय डैड इज अ वेरी स्पोर्ट्सी गाय सो माय डैड इज लाइक अ ब्लैक कैट कमांडर वाज अ कमांडर यू नो इवन लाइक अ प्रॉपर आर्मी गाय मैं ना स्पोर्ट्स में था ना एकेडमिक्स में अच्छा था पढ़ाई मेरी घटिया होती थी बाय गॉड ठीक है इनफैक्ट 11th एंड 12th में स्कोर्ड वेल एंड 12th में स्कोर्ड रियली वेल सो स्टीफंस में हो गया मेरा बट 10th में तो मेरे को पता नहीं था ना 11th 12th में अच्छा हो जाऊंगा 10th में तो घटिया था सो यू नो एंड आई वाज बैड एट एकेडमिक्स आई वाज बैड एट स्पोर्ट्स आई वाज नॉट राइटिंग सो that was this one time there's this race happening in sports day and main race mein haar gaya okay and I like this girl in 10th class okay
yeah
and that girl oh yeah 10th class ki ladki hai to ladki hai to obviously jo race pe jeeta uske paas jayegi
right
the guy lost right
yeah
I actually ran for just for her okay I just ran for her and and पता चला मैं तो लूज हो गया वो लड़की तो उसको भाव दे रही दूसरे लड़के को
yeah
all these things like kind of like this accumulated and like this like made me like cry and I was like यार मेरा इतना घटिया बंदा होना I'm good for nothing you know
oh
I'm like the most good for nothing child ever in this world and I'm not good at anything so okay. I think that was the last time I cried and I think that was it I think 10th class में that was the last day I cried and I think after that I never cried so
So that was the biggest down.
I was not biggest say. down, I would say, but that was a very disappointing period of my life. Down nahi tha wo mere life ka, I would say. But yeah, yeah. disappointing because you kind of see, imagine you are born in this on this world for a purpose. ठीक है?
Yes.
And pata chale you are good for nothing.
Yeah, obviously wo to
so
bahut
hard hoga. So that's the worst thing ever.
yes.
You know?
Or biggest up.
Biggest up. I think it was the time when my launch happened and my book Kalki book launched and my book was bought by Fingerprint and I think that was the time when you know all the biggest people in the industry the literature industry were there and those people who give me bhav when I was writing because there were काफी rejections हुए you know people don't know this I have gotten more than 100-200 rejections from people
Seriously?
I literally was looking through my Yahoo mail. So my Yahoo mail is the oldest mail, मतलब जो earliest mail जो मैं use करता था.
Yeah.
And मैं देख रहा था यार क्या-क्या rejections आए थे मेरे को. It doesn't fit in our list. It is not this. It is not that. It is not good. It is bad. Reply नहीं आता था कभी-कभी तो इतने लोगों को भेजता था.
Okay.
मैं सोच रहा था यार मतलब और अब वही लोग मेरे से किताब मांग रहे हैं.
Yeah.
So, the funny part is that is how life works, you know. And
That is how karma works also.
That is karma. Yeah, I mean, karma नहीं बेचारे उनकी भी गलती नहीं है. अब छोटा रहता है.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, You have to see what I learned from my life was one of the most important thing is to take hold of your destiny.
Yes, true.
Yeah, I mean you can't expect that things are happy gonna happen here themselves, you know.
Yes, yes. Just you have to do your work.
Yeah, because ऐसे Lamborghini चाहिए and मैं सपने में देखूँगा Lamborghini को तो Lamborghini हो जाएगी मेरी. You know, you have to work for it. You have to work for the Lamborghini. Yeah, मुझे चाहिए. So.
Yes. Totally.
Yeah.
So regarding this book, Kalki, where do you get idea?
Your idea to aya. मैं तो बहुत बड़ा cap copy कर रही हूँ. Basically, what happened was that you know my dad was working globally. Okay. And okay. My dad was like, "Yeah, he calls you one day, and he's like, because he lives in Chennai, he works there." So
okay.
He said, "Yeah, Kevin, why don't you write something similar to Bahubali?" So okay. I said, "Ki Dad, मेरे पास 200 करोड़ तो है नहीं." So मतलब, you know, I mean, I don't know why you think that the writing mein you can make epic. So basically, yeah. He said, "You think big, you know, think big and write big, you know, so that people okay. are gonna be like, wow, you know, this is like a spectacle to read about, you know." So
yeah.
it's a visual Bollywoodish spectacle that people want to read about. So that is what I was going for, you know.
Okay.
But yeah, otherwise, I think more or less this was it. And also the fact that I was always a big fan of Star Wars. So oh. yeah, मैं ना Star Wars थोड़ा पसंद था तो मैं क्योंकि storyline is very similar to Star Wars. So have you seen Star Wars?
Yes, that's no, why I like.
Yeah, if you see like Luke Skywalker, he's like a farm boy, right? And he becomes like right. a Jedi and fights Darth Vader, right?
Yes.
The same thing with Kalki. He's like a farm boy who grows up, who loses something. Like, so imagine Kalki loses his village. Luke Skywalker
yes.
loses his uncle and, you know, his aunt and everyone.
Okay.
So it's very similar to that, yeah.
Yeah, so this story by inspired by like any of the incidents is inspired by your life story or your circumstances?
बिल्कुल नहीं यार मैं काल की तो हूँ नहीं मतलब ऐसे
so it's totally fiction.
It's all imagination. I would say mean, the one thing that is inspired from me is the brother relationship. I feel the brother relation. I have a brother. I have a cousin brother who is like my brother only.
Okay.
I'm a single child. But I've grown
yeah.
up with this guy whose name is Ryan, and he's always been like a brother to me,
okay.
like a real brother, as in. And I was very so the relationship between Arjun and Kalki is quite similar to what I have with me and Ryan, you know. So
okay,
I think
so.
Yeah.
That sort of phase is inspired by real life.
Absolutely, and also the relationship between of Kalki and Lakshmi. So that is something that inspired from the girls I met in my life.
Oh, okay. Like other than writing, what are your hobbies?
Yeah, मैं ना बहुत बड़ा फुकरा हूँ. मेरा ना कुछ किसी भी चीज़ में अच्छा नहीं हूँ. By God. है ना सिर्फ एक चीज़ में अच्छा हूँ वो है writing. That's it.
No, I have heard about somewhere like you like watching Netflix movies and all.
Yeah. वो Netflix तो होता है. वो क्या hobby का है यार वो. तो kind of. You know, I like video games. One can say I used to play guitar when I was small, but that was my mom's forcefulness only. कि नहीं तू guitar सीख. कभी मन नहीं किया सीख रहे हैं. But yeah, I mean, other than see, as long as I can remember, the one thing that I inherited myself was writing. That's it. You know. Other than that, everything
yeah.
was forced on me, or other than that, everything was like ki hakal lo side mein.
Okay.
Yeah.
So does writing energize you or exhaust you?
ये ना by God question 10 बार आ चुका है मेरे को. ये कहाँ से लेके आया? कहाँ से ये question bank है हमारा?
नहीं.
By
these
God,
are the
literally common. I'm giving interviews the last 10-15 days, मतलब 2-3 days, and you know it's like bloody. I mean the same question comes in every fucking question bank. Why is it like that? I want to know. I'm very curious now. Where does this question come from?
Well, like these are the questions from recent interviews. Like we come across the people who tell their stories. Like some says we have writer's block. Some say we don't have.
Achha.
Some says we believe in it. Some says we don't.
Achha.
So, like directly asking, do you have writer's block?
हाँ तो ये पूछा ना writer's block है या नहीं है? Yeah,
so do you believe in writer block?
My writing block doesn't come when the story is very good. Pata hai? My writing block comes when the story is bad. Mere saath ye hai. Aur main notice kari writer's block kabhi aata hai agar tumhari story is not good.
Okay.
Yeah. So I was writing this book called Sinbad. Okay. The story is fakol. Okay.
Oh.
It's very bad. And I had the hardest time writing that book. Hardest time. While when I was writing Narsimha, I finished it in 3 weeks.
Great.
Such an epic and amazing book.
Yeah.
So writer's block is, I think, depends on the quality of what you're writing. I think that is the best way I can summarize for you.
Like based on this, give us a depth of your writing. Like first, how do you plot? Then how you start writing, or how you started imagining?
So I'll just tell you. I have an overarching plot, which is basically the ye hoega.
Okay.
Then I have the character development, the character motivation, the conflicts. Ye conflicts hoega book mein.
Okay.
And then the dialogues, everything, that is something improvised. That is something that I go as I go. And most of the time, ki jo maine plot kiya hota hai, uska bilkul opposite chale jata hai. Then I have to, you know, rework the outline. Ki acha ab ye outline mein kya karna padega. So, yeah. So, I have, what I'll do is, if you want, I can, I don't know how you'll publish, how the podcast will pata nahi chalega, but I have like diary entries of all the Narsimha plot lines that I made, which is basically ki pehle maine ek plot line kiya, fir usko hataya, kyunki change hogi story thodi si, to fir maine ek aur plot line kiya. So, I have all these bullet points, yeah.
So, after that, you have started working on it?
Yeah, then I started working on it. I write the first 3 chapters pehle, after overarching plot, I make the first 3 chapters. I'm like, okay, is this interesting enough for me to continue? So, okay. The first 3 chapters, see, because for the readers also, the first 3 chapters are the defining moment, right, of the book.
Yes, obviously.
Yeah,
I do agree with that.
Yeah.
Because if you don't feel connected to the first 2-3 chapters, then almost a week skip that book.
Exactly. You're like, yaar, meko nahi padhna abhi aur. Because novels will be like, oh, meko 50th chapter mein kitna maza aaya. So, that is not how it works. But yeah, I mean, so I make sure that the first 3 chapters are brilliant, and after that, I make sure that ki acha ab ye maze aa rahe hain mujhe, now I'm gonna plot out the entire story.
Okay, so do you think as a reader while writing? Do you think as a reader or as a writer?
That's a good question because I don't think zyada.
Because like if you compare all the other fiction books, there are some of them are try to be original, others are deliver what the readers want, like it's like conflict.
Yaar dekho, I am a reader first and a writer second. I'll be very honest. There are a lot of writers out there who are writers first and readers second. I believe that a writer should always be a reader first, because then only
he will
get to know ki kya chahiye.
Yes.
Mein, you know, I mean, kya hona chahiye book mein? So I feel that I was always very very conscious about what I was writing in terms of whether this scene will be liked by the audience or not.
Reader or not?
Yeah. I mean, kya kya yani pasand aayega? Will this be interesting enough for them to continue to the next chapter? And that is very important if you're writing a commercial book.
Yes, that's true.
Yeah.
So, based on this, like you said, every writer is a reader. So, what are your favorite books?
Godfather, the Percy Jackson series. I like Cassandra Clare's Mortal Instruments. They're very well written, very well plotted actually, not written, but very well plotted. I like Brandon Sanderson's Mistborn and Stormlight Archive. I like Hobbit. I think Hobbit is where I mostly get ideas from.
So any Indian author?
I don't think so. I think Indian author, I read Ashwin Sanghi's Vishnathi, so I really like that.
So, okay, we will rephrase the question. Like at the age of 14, you like, tum kaise the aur abhi kaise ho? Like the difference in this 8 to 10 years.
मैं कैसा था 14 में?
Yeah, like your thoughts, your process, then right now कैसे हो? Like
I was a very underconfident child in at the age of 14. I didn't know where I was going. I didn't know what my life was gonna be, was gonna turn out like. I didn't know कि मैं writing कर भी सकता हूँ नहीं कर सकता, whether I'm good at it or not.
Yeah.
So मैं बड़ा बेकार बच्चा था. By God, मैं इतना I had no scope in terms of whether what I will be in my life, and I think now I know, now I'm clear, now I'm very confident about who I am.
Yeah.
And I think now you gave me a very good question. I'm like, going through that phase, like, shit, I didn't know these things about myself.
Oh, yeah. Now you can think on it and you can write somewhere.
नहीं यार इतना नहीं है.
Not a book, but in your diary.
Yeah, the diary नहीं लिखता मैं.
Oh. So right now you are in the ladder of success. So how does a success look like to you?
Success looks very scary, yeah, because you know you never know when you can fall.
Oh.
You know because you're right, you're going up and as कितना भी तुम ऊपर चले जाओगे ना ladder के, तो नीचे है ना वो बहुत गहराई होती रहती है, right?
Right, जितना ऊपर जाओगे जितना गहराई बढ़ेगी.
Exactly, and if you fall, you fall the hardest.
Yes.
जितना ऊपर जाओगे.
Yes, actually, at this stage, when you become a success, like people try to act on your thoughts, you react on your thoughts, like what you say, what you believe. So yeah, they try to follow you. So you have to be very conscious while you're doing whatever.
No, absolutely. Yeah. Are you referring to Chetan Bhagat's Me Too?
No, actually, I am not a Chetan Bhagat fan.
I know, but I thought you liked love stories.
Yeah, but not Chetan Bhagat love stories at all.
Which love story do you like?
Well, some from the Ravindra, then Durjoy Dutta. Then if it comes to inspiration, then Savi Sharma, then Michelle Album, and Paul Cholo.
Acha, that's great. Yeah, that's great.
Like, do you believe writing has a power?
Writing has a power
to change people's mind, to change what they think.
Okay, this is gonna be a long answer because you know I really this is a very good answer question because I really believe in how it changes lives. Just hold on, yeah, I'm just actually charging.
Yeah, sure. Yes, no worries.
I'm putting it on my own. Yeah, so anyway, so what I'm just trying to say to you is that the reason why I write fantasy, you know, is because it kind of shows that that writing has this power to change a person's life, you know. And people write all these inspirational romances, and I think that's fine, you know. It changes, just you like Nasavi Sharma, right? And
yes,
it kind of changed your life also in some way or the other, right?
Right.
I go the way, the most subtle way. I don't go the direct way. I have read Savi Sharma, and for her particular audience, that's a very good book, you know.
Yes.
And but I write in a more subtle way, and I believe that, you know, fantasy or mythology, you know, it's a way to it's a way to learn about your history, about where you come from, and it's a way to actually just learn how to be a better person, right? I think, yes, books make you become a better person, you know?
Yes.
And I think that is something that no Netflix or no Amazon Prime can give you, you know.
True.
Yeah. So I think that is something that I really want to keep doing, because when you see Arjun, for instance, you know, trying to save his brother's life. It's about brotherhood, you know. It's about loyalty towards your brother, you know.
Right.
And it's something that these are the attributes that people should have in them, right? And it's about being a good person at the end of the day. So yeah, I mean, that's how I believe that writing does have the power to change and inspire people. Yeah.
Yes, even I do believe that when you read something, you try to adapt that in your life.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yes. Next question is, like you said, writing has a power. Where I was.
That's okay.
Like you have any superpower from your book. So what it could be?
Achha, if any superpower from my book?
Yeah.
From my book only or from like usually like other books also?
Like, no, it's from your book.
Okay. So I would love to have the power of channeling, which is basically going back in time and meeting avatars. I think that will be like a really cool way to enter new worlds and new timelines. And yeah, I think yeah, that would be something, some superpower I would like to have.
Okay, so I find like you are the most talkative person. So actually, where do you get inspiration if you are like going to the depression phase or something sad phase?
Depression phase or sad phase? Depression is not a phase per se. You know, I would always believe that depression is a medical illness. You know, and it's yes. It's a proper illness. You know, it's not something it happens for a while and then goes away. You know.
Fine.
Yeah, but for a sad face, I would say for depression needs medical attention. So that is something that you can't learn from having a...
That's a different... Yeah. But
like, for a sad face, I would say I have gone through a lot of sad faces. It's not like ki yaar main har roz hi khush rehta hu, you know. There have been days where I've been so fucked up in the head. I'm like, yaar, itta ghatiya din ja raha hai mera. My God. And you know what's the best thing I do that those days? I sleep.
Okay.
So I don't let anything bother me. I just sleep.
Okay.
Because I believe the bad days come, but they also go. You know, that's the best thing about bad days. They come, but they go also.
Yes.
And obviously, the person who's having like multiple bad days, for them, I would say you have to have a good mentor in your life who will look after you. Okay. At least in the beginning phase, you need to have a certain level of goal and purpose in your life that this is what I want to achieve in my life. And you need to start doing that to achieve that. Something to, like, you know, take a first step towards achieving that. If you do all these three things, the sad phase will be just a day, which will just be a day, bad day, and then the next day it will be a good day again, you know. So you have those three things, yeah.
Yeah, so actually we almost done with these questions, almost like the we wanted to ask. Yes, but like let's talk about the upcoming book Kalkit 2. Like, what are your thoughts?
What are my thoughts? I think it's a better book than Kalki 1. It's more focused. It's more it's bigger. It's it has more twists and turns. It has developed character development, which just basically maneuver the reader into something and twist the reader into something totally unexpected. A lot of action scenes. So yeah.
So like that's all. I guess we don't want suspense.
Of course, I'm not gonna give spoilers. People are asking about spoilers, but I don't know. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going to read it in maybe next week or next month.
Of course, you're coming to the 8th book launch, no? So
yeah, actually.
Let's meet up. Let's do a live interview from your Instagram.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
Yeah, during the party. But I don't know how the internet connection will be. So that can come shitty.
We will see.
Yeah. So.
from this book Kalki 2, what is the most difficult thing to write about from to write a character from a different gender, opposite gender.
I feel okay. So that's something that someone asked me before also. Basically, one should always realize that when you're writing a female character, so most male writers, you know what they do is they write a female character just for having a romance angle to the story, right? I always believe that's not the way to go. If you're writing a female character, have her dreams, have her aspirations, have her flaws up front, okay? And what happens is most writers forget that. They're like, that woman only has one purpose in the novel, and that is to actually, you know, make her the love interest of the guy. And the guy has like all the dreams and all the goals and everything, the flaws. Right. But the girl doesn't, right? So there's one flaw. There is one problem with the. So that is something that I avoid. And the other thing which I believe that a writer should always notice is that not to give a certain level of biasness towards the women characters. What happens is that most people try to be pseudo-feminist. You know what pseudo-feminist is?
Yeah.
so pseudo feminist, you know, they try to add the pseudo feminism inside them. So what happens in that is that they try to show that the woman is all powerful, all great, all wonderful. You know, she's the most beautiful person in the world. You know.
Yes.
And and thing is, you have to just make her flawed. You know, you have to make her as you will write a female male character. You know.
Yes, absolutely. It should be balanced.
It should be balanced, exactly. You know, feminism is about equality. You know, it's not about women being on the top or man being down.
Yes. Actually, they both have different pros and cons. Like, some mains are physically strong, women are mentally strong. Like, we cannot judge each other by any other qualities. Oh,
yaar, tune female bodybuilder thi dekhi. Maar degi. By God.
It's interesting.
Physical, you see, the strength is something that... strength is, there are a lot of different ways of you can vary strength in a different manners. You know, there's one mental strength, there's physical strength, there's emotional strength, you know,
strength, right?
So for instance a nun in an orphanage who's handling like 50 children has more emotional strength than a businessman who's doing a 50 crore deal, you know,
right? So that, yes.
Yeah, so that's the thing, you know. I mean, theek hai.
Okay. So our last question is, like, what advice do you have for all the writers, readers?
Advice kya de rahe
ho? No, readers, not writers.
अच्छा writers readers को दे रहा है. Readers को क्या advice दूँगा मैं?
Yes.
पढ़े किताबें. चिल मारो यार. Readers को कौन advice देता है? Readers तो यार जी, we live in a democratic country. Readers, about whatever you want to, यार, and stop making a fuss about everything. So. I mean,
okay.
I think one of the major things is that the best advice I can give to the readers is to start being a little bit intelligent. I'm not saying that dumb, but they read a lot of dumb books in India.
Yeah.
In India. So, and they like it. And I'm like, why do they like it? That's such a dumb book. And
yes.
And yeah, I mean, we are moving forward. We are in a globalized world and we are moving so much. And I think, you know, I think you need to start reading something which is intelligent, which is not intelligent only, but just something that that is not dumb. I think that is the best way to go say it. I don't know. Yeah.
Okay, so let it be that advice. So if you want to tell, like, to all the listeners, to the young generation, what should do they to achieve their dreams, or like the way you did?
Okay. I think to achieve your dreams, I think rather than just thinking about it, go for it. Stop thinking about it. I think there's no novelty in dreaming. Dreaming is good as long as you're sleeping. But after that, you wake up and you have to now start working for your dream, you know. And most people, what they do is they forget working about it. They just dream, you know. And
yes.
Also, the second thing that you need to do is you need to start just believing in yourself, man. I mean, you need to start just be like, fuck the world, I'm going to do it, you know. There have been days where I get underconfident, you know. I still remember the time in the beginning, people didn't like Kalki Book 1 in terms of the content. They thought that it will not work. Yes. It's too big. It's too many characters, too many plot lines, too many subplots, you know.
Yes.
And... But you need to believe in yourself. You know, if you have the capability of it, you believe in yourself and just go for it, man. I mean, the thing is, that book sold 50,000 copies plus, you know.
Yes.
And most mythology books nowadays, except for Amish and Anand Nilkantan and all these big writers, you know, they don't even cross 10,000 copies. So the very fact that it crossed 50,000 copies, that means something, that, you know, that if you have confidence in what you are writing, in what you're doing, actually, you can achieve it, man. So that's the one thing.
Yeah. So thank you so much, Kevin, sir, for being on the podcast. So guys, do you love this podcast? If you love this, let me know in the comment section. If you love this, please do share with your friends and inspire every person on the earth. And do subscribe to the podcast. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.